Goodbye's the saddest something I believe must say goodbye. Goodbye's the saddest word I'll ever hear. Goodbye's the last time I will.
Until then, goodbye. Thank you. Good afternoon, friends and family. Please take your seat as we get ready for the tributes. Celebrate the life of Catherine Hingson today. We now call on Clement Wool for a tribute. Clement Wool.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Clement Wool-Solage, and I'm a friend of Garfield's. First of all, I'd like to express heartfelt condolences to my dear friend Garfield and, of course, the Hingson family, the entire family. This is a tribute poem composed in remembrance and in celebration of the life of Miss Catherine. It's an honor to be able to read this poem today on behalf of Garfield. It's entitled Footprints in the Sand. You kept me awake last night. Heard you whisper. Some say I have gone. Others say I have arrived. As you mourn my passing, my Lord and others are happy to see me again on the other side. For I'm a flower that has just turned its face to a new sun. On the coastline of my mind, I watch the sand slip into the ocean. Clouds come floating into my resting soul. No longer to carry rain or usher storm, but to add color to my sunset sky on distant hills reflecting the sunset's light. Her absence is like the sky spread over everything. A sky ablaze with stars. And while there are millions of stars out there, a visible cluster of 83 stars adorn the sky, emitting a bright red glow, shades of the blood of the Lazarus heart. Your footprints in the sand, in the world you left behind. The greater the love, the greater the grief. I can't help wondering, though, whether the dearly departed also feel the pain of separation. With eyes wide shut, I lament. The stars are not wanted now. Turn off the lights. Block the first sunlight of July. Pack up the moon and dismantle the sun. Pour away the ocean. And yet, with eyes wide open, I reflect. Your memory is my star, my moon, my sun, my midnight, my talk, my song, my July. I hear your voice in my ears like splashing waterfalls. The beauty and spring and summer of our lives, I remember your warmth, your faith, your youth, your hugs, your laughter, your humanity. The good you lived while you were strong. But it's time to move on. You're crossing that bridge. There's light through that window. Heaven's waiting. Time is a space between me and you. The body succumbs to time, but time succumbs to love. Your footprints have left the most pleasurable afterflow and afterglow in the sand. Your soul's at rest in God's grace. A grace too amazing to imagine. I will not stand at your grave and weep, for you're not there. You're the gentle rain, the summer breeze, the calm ocean waves, the moonlight at dusk, the golden footprints in the sand. The deceased are always looking down on us, they say, while we are dancing to a song and having a meal. They're looking down through the glass bottom boats of heaven. And so, as you go gently into the good night, what can we do? I say finally. Nothing, she says. Nothing. Let me finish this one alone. I will be at the watchtower, overseeing, protecting, and nurturing the fruits of my earthly endowment. Rejoice, for I have arrived, and come to me someday. Thank you.
Thank you, Clement. We now have the eulogy, which will be done by Hanson Narsis.
Yeah, you gave a little more than you take, and you tried to fix more than you break. You're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain. There's a place for people like you. You stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak. If you shine a little light and give sight to those who lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when the days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. Catherine Hingson, better known as Mom, Kathy, Ferrella, to some close friends and family members, She was born on the 16th of March, 1949 in Saltibus to Etes and Josephine Lawrence. Kafi was one of 14 children, 10 from her mother's side and 4 from her father's side. Kafi attended school at the Library Infant School, but left at the age of 8 to raise her siblings. At the tender age of 15 years, Kafi moved from the South to live with an aunt in Castries who helped her raise her siblings. Catherine, mom, had 10 children, namely Simon, Casper, Peter, Patricia, Ermine, Philip, Felix, Garfield, Mario, and Sari. Mom was incredibly proud of all her children and their different personalities, qualities, and the career paths they chose. In the years to follow, she carried the same pride and interest in every one of her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. They were always a favorite topic of conversation for her. Kafi always worked extremely hard and sometimes worked two jobs. She worked at the Government House and the Venezuelan Ambassador's Residence as a cook. In the later years, working as a housemaid in some of the island's primary villas and also becoming the head housekeeper at Cap Pavilion, a job she loved dearly. She was proud of the staff she trained and managed there, who in return loved mom equally. Kafi was driven to provide for her family and to give them a good life. She achieved this in so many ways. Firstly, moving many times, but always to better living conditions and for better opportunities. She loved her home at Hill 20 Babano, where she enjoyed the neighborhood. She was determined that each of her children would grow up to be independent, respectful, and proud. So, each of them was taught how to cook, clean, sew, iron, and keep a good house in order. And there were days where it was either 4 hours in church or 5 hours preparing food with her. Catherine married Austin Hingston in May 1961, a tailor who stayed home and looked after the children. Catherine ran a very, very tight shift at home. Everyone had their chores and they had to be done without failure. Kafi did not tolerate any back chat, rudeness, rolling of eyes from any of her kids, grandkids, or any other family member. Those who did not listen would eventually feel the wrath of Hurricane Catherine, dreaded much by everyone. Home was a central point of all activities for all of the children and their friends. Mom was always cooking. She loved cooking and feeding everybody. She fed everyone. She always said that was how she was raised as a child by her great-grandmother and great-grandfather. There was always food for if anyone passed by. From Peter's Carnival Reveler friends, the DKs, that's Garfield, Felix, Philip, Kyle, Tony, Trevor, and Pito, Mario's football friends, Sari's work friends, they all passed through the house and they all got fed. She also welcomed Mario's friend Placid that came for a night and stayed there for several years. Kafi never turned away any of her children's friends. She offered an open heart and an open home, the ultimate role model of kindness, love, and selflessness. Mom had 26 grandchildren. The oldest of her grandsons, Leon, whom she had a very special bond with. She helped her daughter Umin to raise him while she was at work. Mom would speak so fondly of how, when he was a small boy, and how he fitted under her breast. Every time Umin would visit Mom, she would video call Leon for them to chat, especially as he grew up and had moved overseas. However, the bond and closeness stayed. She was a very proud, happy, and proud of the gentleman he had become. Mom always would tell her children and grandchildren how much she loved them and was always praying for them to be happy and healthy. Once Kaffee retired, she had more time to spend with her grandchildren and help instill discipline and respect. Kaffee's love and desire to take care for her grandchildren was extensive. She helped out with the childcare for Malaika and even went to the UK for 6 months to make sure she got to know and help with her 24th grandchild. On her return to St. Lucia, she continued with grandchildren, Zeta and Zoe. Kaffee enjoyed traveling in her later years. Having worked tirelessly for most parts of her life, she got little opportunity to holiday abroad. So once she retired, she took the opportunity to catch up and see many places in the world. She enjoyed shopping in America and her visits to England. Mom loved the cold weather, but often shared how she dreaded how much walking she had to do to get around in the city of London. She loved when she got to see Buckingham Palace and Big Ben. Kaffee made friends with everyone, and everyone loved her because she was respectful and friendly. Gran came from Barbados in 1984 to live with Mom and the family. Mom now relaxed from the cooking since Gran was there. Mom took care of Gran with the help of Mario and Sari since they were the last at home. These were wonderful days. Mom enjoyed going to the cathedral to mass with her daughter Umin on Saturday nights, where she met with friends both old and new. She was always early, and sometimes her daughter would watch her standing by the church door with a couple of elderly ladies chatting away. There came a time she was unable to get to the local transports because of her knees. After the knee operations, she started going to the Good Shepherd Church, Babano, with a friend and neighbor, Miss Paul. She would always call her daughter Umin to let her know what the sermon was about. On Sundays, she watched Hot 7 TV for the Sunday Mass. She loved listening to Father Setut. Kaffee was extremely generous to everyone. If she was given a bag of mangoes or a bag of lime or 3 hands of green bananas, the first thing she would do is separate them and give some to her neighbor, any friend visiting, or members of the family. It made no sense to her to have a surplus of anything when other people she cared about had little at the time. She loved helping people in any little way she could. Her love for her family was unconditional. If you did something bad, however, and she was not happy, and she did not agree, she would let you know. Kaffee was always honest. She would never support any member of the family if they were in the wrong, and she would let them know from a place of love. It did not matter which son, which daughter, which niece, nephew, cousin, godchild, or friend. If you were wrong, she would let you know you are wrong. And the only way you could have her support was to make things right. Kaffee will always be remembered for a sense of fun. She had a very memorable laugh, and when she laughed deeply, her eyes would sparkle. Kathy was the first to laugh at herself and shared a joke. Kathy loved deeply and shared unselfishly. Kathy leaves a huge legacy, not just in the size of the family she created, but the values, love, and lessons she gave to each and everyone. Just a few months ago, as Kathy was experiencing some health issues that she had, Kathy was experiencing some health issues, so she spoke to each of her children and asked that when it is her time to go, not to be sad, but to know that she had the best family and had lived a happy and love-filled life with them. That she did not have to ask for anything more, and because of this, when God decided to take her, she would go in peace and peace of mind and joy in her heart. I imagine Kathy saying to you now, we give every effort we can muster to anything we believe we can be when we dream our dreams. When we live, we give devotion to the story which we wish our lives to be. We are not guaranteed to win for our efforts, steadfast as they may be. So the quality of our time matters, despite our best efforts. This life can play out like snakes and ladders, and when we fall, we must climb. As if the simple act of standing has brought you closer to the cosmos that you have previously been. As if all the stars you've seen have been busy looking back, taking notices and keeping track of which wishes need granting. They heard you ask for strength. Show them you haven't wasted it. Get up. I picture mom saying, this is really for you, not me. Now that I'm dead, when my coffin is being taken out, you must never think I'm missing this world. Don't shed any tears. Don't lament or feel sorry. I am not falling into a monster's abyss. When you see my corpse is being carried, do not cry for my leaving. I am not leaving. I'm arriving at eternal love. When you leave me in the grave, do not say goodbye. Remember, a grave is only a curtain for the paradise behind. You'll only see me descending into a grave. Now watch me rise. How can there be an end? When the sun sets and the moon goes down, it looks like the end. It seems like a sunset, but in reality, it is a dawn. When the grave locks you up, that is when your soul is freed. Have you ever seen a seed fall into earth and not rise with new life? Why should you doubt the rise of a seed named Kathy? Have you ever seen a bucket lowered into a well coming back empty? Why lament for a soul when it can come back like Joseph from the well? When for the last time you close your mouth, your words will belong to the world of no place and no time. Rest in peace, Mom.
Thank you. Will the pallbearers take the position? Peter Hingson, Garfield Hingson, Mario Hingson, Sari Hingson, Leon Joseph, and Kendall Satney. Our officiating priest is Monsignor Patrick Anthony. Please stand.
Good afternoon, sisters and brothers.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. It's a rainy afternoon, but we welcome you in faith of God who shows showers of mercies upon those who believe in Him and whom He has called home. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
We now sprinkle the body with the holy water that recalls our baptism and Catherine's baptism. And then we place the pall on the coffin, also a symbol of baptism. Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Father of mercies and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our afflictions and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from Him. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Together.
Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
I bless the body of Catherine in the holy water that recalls her baptism. Of which St. Paul writes, all of us who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him. So that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we've been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. And now to the foreign family, this welcomes. In the day of her baptism, Catherine put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed with glory. Let's take the body of our sister of the eye.
Welcome to the Thanksgiving service celebrating the life of our beloved Catherine Hingson. We all join in the entrance hymn, Walk with Me, O My Lord.
Thank you.
In Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. Let us pray for us.
Our first reading is from Ecclesiasticus chapter 3, verses 1 to 11. Ecclesiasticus chapter 3, verses 1 to 11. The first reading will be proclaimed by Ziggy Hingson.
There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing. A time for knocking down, a time for building. A time for tears, a time for laughter. A time for mourning, and a time for dancing. A time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them up. A time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing. A time for searching, a time for losing. A time for keeping, a time for throwing away. A time for tearing, a time for sowing. A time for keeping silent, a time for speaking. A time for loving, a time for hating. A time for war, a time for peace. What does a man gain for the efforts that he makes? I contemplate the task that God gives mankind to labor at. All he has does is apart for its time. But though he has permitted man to consider time in its whole, man cannot comprehend the work of God from beginning to end. The word of the Lord.
Our response to this reading, the Lord is my shepherd, he lives.
The voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven.
Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
All rise for the proclamation of the gospel.
Happy are those who die in the Lord. Now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them. Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, Lord.
From chapter 17, verses 24 to 26. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, I want those who have given me to be with me where I am, so that they may always see the glory you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Father, righteous one, the world has not known you, but I have known you, and these have known that you have sent me. I have made your name known to them and will continue to make it known, so that the love with which you love me may be in them, so that I may be in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are gathered together this afternoon under cloudy skies to bid farewell to Catherine, a woman whom, as you heard from Hans in the eulogy, is a woman of many things, a woman of strength, a woman of courage, a woman of faith, a woman of generosity, a mother and a grandmother and great-grandmother, one who mothered so many, who did so much. A woman whose life can be captured as a bundle of love and self-giving and sharing. A life that has touched so many lives. One life that has touched so many lives. In her children and grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and friends and associates. We can say that a bundle of love that is one life, that has dissipated and has shed love and has reached out and touched so many. When Lorenzo called me to pray for Catherine, I went to the hospital, and there I found that the children in love, loved ones gathered together as a community of love, all in their pain and suffering and desire, wishing well, agony, for Catherine was dying. A room filled with love and deep emotion. That was just for me, just a symbol of what her life had been. A room full of love and care and concern, as her life had been a life filled with love and care and concern and affection and devotion and giving and sharing. To see your mother, your grandmother on a bed and not able to do anything for her, and can only pray that she may transition well, helps us all face the limitations of our capacity as human beings. Yes, we may have all that we think we have, but then comes a moment when we are faced with the limitations of who we are. The time when not even a doctor can do anymore. All a priest can do is just pray. The time when we meet the limits in which our lives are now simply in the hand of God. Entrusted to the hand of God. And so, at a moment like that, we say to God, look, which is what we did, Lord, receive Catherine into your hands. And as he receives her, we pray that she would be received with all the retinue of achievements, life lived, a life of service, a life of sharing, a life of caring, a life of deep, deep, deep affection, a life of nurturing, that all of that will be received by God as a life lived, well lived, a life lived with gratitude. And so, when we gather today to bid farewell to our sister, and we hear the words, yes, there is a time for everything. A time to be born, a time to die. Yes, there is a time for everything in life. But for us, sisters and brothers, the time that really matters is the time when we lived our lives as God, who created us in his own image and likeness, really asked us to live our lives. How? God, who created us in his own image and likeness, is a God of love. Is a God of mercy and compassion. Is a God who always gives. And a God who wants us to live in the manner in which we are made. So that when we live as godly people, living in the likeness of God in whom we are made, then we can be sure that when the moment comes and we return to God from whom we came, we'll receive the reward of a life lived well. But sisters and brothers, as Ecclesiastes tells us, in this life, there are times for all things. There are opportunities for all kinds of things. And unfortunately, for so many people, instead of giving and loving and sharing, so much of their life is causing pain and hurt and wickedness and doing evil and destruction. So many people, so much of their life is that. And it is tragic, because unfortunately, what you sow is what you reap. And if you live a life of wickedness, a life of hatred, a life of violence, a life of destruction, then you will sow the seeds of that kind of life. But if you sow the seeds of goodness and kindness, then that will be your reward. Today, we thank God for the love that Catherine has so spread in her life, that so many of us, so many of you know full well. We thank God for that life of love, and we ask the Lord to welcome her home in those beautiful words, "Well done, good and faithful servant." But even as we bid Catherine farewell, we are the ones who remain. We are the ones who remain, still with time left to see what we will make of our life. A time for love, a time for hatred, a time for war, a time for peace. What will we make of the rest of our lives? We have the choice. We have the opportunity. We pray that Catherine, who loved the children and the grandchildren, great-grandchildren so much, will intercede for all of them, that they may make the right choices, that they may live the right way, so that their lives may one day be rewarded like Catherine with the mercy and compassion of God. Let us pray that the legacy of Catherine will be lived on and passed on and handed on by her children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren until the day when they will join her in the kingdom, receiving the reward promised by God to those who live in a righteous way. As the gospel said today, "Lord, I want those you have given me to be with me, so that they may see the glory that you promised me from the beginning." We pray that Catherine today will see that glory, and that her children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren and their children will live in such a way that one day they too will enjoy the glory of God forever. Amen.
Family members, we've been in prayers. Please come up.
Sisters and brothers, please stand. Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayer to his.
For the church. We pray for the church, the clergy, and the religious, and all God's people, that God may continue to bless them in their ministry, grant them wisdom and knowledge, and they may be able to guide God's people in the ways of truth, justice, and love. We pray to the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord.
For the government and people of St. Lucia. Dear Lord, we pray for the government and people of St. Lucia that your Holy Spirit may be the instrument that drives every undertaking of theirs. Grant them insight, wisdom, discernment, and knowledge that they may guide your people and the affairs of the country in justice, integrity, and peace. May St. Lucia, our patron saint, intercede for us and continue to be the bearer of light to shine in the dark places of this country and its peoples and free us from the disease of crime and violence. We pray to the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord, Kumbaya. Somebody's praying, Lord, Kumbaya.
Prayer for the family. We pray for the family of Catherine Hinkson, especially her children, that God may grant them peace, strength, and consolation. As they mourn the loss of their loved one, knowing that death is a gateway to eternal life and freedom, we pray to the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord.
The deceased. We pray for our granny, Catherine Hinkson, that God in his mercies may grant her forgiveness of her sins and grant her a place with his angels and saints in his heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord. Somebody's praying.
For the sick and suffering. We pray for the sick and suffering from all kinds of ailments and disease, especially from the COVID-19 virus, that God may grant them all the healing necessary and the courage and strength to perceive. Help them to recognize that their suffering can never be in vain, as Jesus himself endured suffering for our own redemption. We pray to the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord. Somebody's praying, Lord. Kumbaya.
Let's ask our Blessed Mother, the Queen and Gate of Heaven, to intercede for us and for Catherine as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives are purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please sit. We will now have our collection. As we sing together, this world is not my own.
This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels stand with me from heaven's open door.
The signing of the registers. We call on the four witnesses: Garfield Hingson, Mario Hingson, Sari Hingson, and Leon Joseph.
Together and feel alright. Whoa. love to ask. Is there a place for the hopeless sinner who has hurt all mankind just to save his soul? Believe me. To fight this holy Armageddon. For when the Lord comes, there will be no Jew. I pity all those whose chances grow thinner. There ain't no hiding place from the Father of creation. Singing.
Amen. Thank you, Stephian and friends.
Let us stand.
Please stand.
So indeed, despite the rain, despite everything, everything's going to be all right with God. So we put our faith and our trust in God that everything will be all right.
Amen.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Catherine, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Catherine again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will guard us together again in the joy of His kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. So once again, I will sprinkle the coffin with holy water and then incense the body, asking that our prayers may rise like incense before the throne of God. And then we'll invite the family afterwards around the coffin.
As we're saying, all I ask of you, of God, come to her aid, hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Place your hands on the coffin. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Catherine in the sure and certain hope that together for all who died in Christ shall rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn to us and listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Catherine, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. Eternal rest grant unto our Lord.
And yet perpetual life shall be upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Let us take the body of our sister to its place of final repose.
Our recessional hymn, I Am Walking on My Way to the Lord.
To the Lord who's waiting there for me, so let your joy and
Thank you. Since Almighty God has called our sister from this life to himself, we commit the body to the earth from which it is made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal body to be like his in glory. We commend our sister Catherine to the Lord. May the Lord receive her and raise up her body on the last day. Let us pray for Catherine to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Catherine has nourished your body and blood. Grant us, you raise the dead to life. Give our sister Catherine eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister to the joys of heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously.
Enter to the earth of salvation. Give up fellowship with all your saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Comfort us in our sorrow and the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Again, we pray the Lord's prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us evil in
for thine is the kingdom to
come. We ask for Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal restaurant unto our Lord. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
We have soul and the souls of all the faithful departed. In the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Come, our Lord. Amen.
So, now, it's over to you, Albert.
Okay, so we come out and we have to go.
Hey, okay?
Last time.
Tell me the best.
That's the best.
Tell me the best.
All right.
Tell me the best.
The small ones, but we have two.
Only rose.
You
have.
Yes, you that's rose. What I said.
Everybody
have
the rose.
Anyone?
Send
a rose.
Send
a rose. Send a rose. That'd be good.
What's that?
Of pleasure was from my side.
Oh, my God. Lord, my shepherd.
Yes, which song we can sing again, Miss Paul?
Hey, Auntie.
Bless you. Bless the Lord, the wise shepherd.
Bring down, eh? Bring me down. Thank you.
is a promise of a lifetime of love. Now I know there is no other love like a mother's love for her child. And I know a love so complete, something must leave, must say goodbye. Goodbye's the saddest word I'll ever hear. Goodbye's the last time I will hold you near. Someday you'll say that word and I will cry. It'll break my heart to hear you say to me, turned a young one into a woman. And mama, all I ever needed was a guarantee of you loving me.
promise of a lifetime of love. Now I know there is no other love like a mother's love for her child. And I know a love so complete, someday must leave, must say goodbye. Goodbye's the saddest word I'll ever hear. Goodbye's the last time I will hold you near. Someday you'll say that word and I will cry. It'll break my heart to hear you say gave love to me. Turned a young one into a woman. Mama, all I ever needed was a guarantee of you loving me. 'Cause I know I'm
baby. Intuited. And mama, all you had to offer was a promise of a lifetime of love. Now I know goodbye's the same.
Someday must leave, must say goodbye. Goodbye's the saddest word I'll ever hear. Goodbye's the last time I will hold you near. Someday you'll say that word and I will cry. It'll break my heart to hear you say goodbye. Gave love to me, turned a young one to a woman. And mama, all I ever needed was a guarantee of you loving me. 'Cause I know a lifetime of love. Now I
love for her child. And I know a love so complete, someday must leave, must say goodbye. Goodbye's the saddest word I'll ever hear. Goodbye's the last time I will hold you near. Someday you'll say that word and I will cry. It'll break my heart to hear you say goodbye. Gave love to me, turned a young one into a woman. And mama, all I ever needed was a guarantee of you loving me. 'Cause I know all you have.
is a promise of a lifetime of love. Now I know there is no other love like a mother's love for her child. And I know a love so complete, something say goodbye. Goodbye's the saddest word I'll ever hear. Goodbye's the last time I will hold you near. Someday you'll say that word and I will cry. It'll break my heart to hear you say